Howdy. In this segment, we're going to look at CVP analysis for multiple products. So we'll be looking at breakeven and profit analysis calculations when a company sells 2, 3, 4, or more products. First, recall what sales mix is. It is simply the relative proportion in which each product is sold. So if a company expects to sell 10,000 units and they sell product A and product B, the sales mix, if, say, for product A we expect 4,000 units of sales, and for product B we expect 6,000 units, that's our total of 10,000 units. We could say that our sales mix is 40% product A, 60% product B. These numbers are calculated by simply taking the sales for each product A, 4,000 units, and divide by total sales of 10,000 units. And for product B, it's 6,000 units divided by 10,000 units. Why is sales mix important? Well, simply put, it's because some products are more profitable than others. For our CVP analysis calculations, we must factor in this sales mix, but it really doesn't change our calculations very much. We will typically use the contribution margin ratio method when we have multiple product companies, and our break-even point can be calculated. Overall sales dollars is equal to total fixed cost plus desired profit divided by the overall contribution margin ratio. So when I say overall sales or overall contribution margin ratio, I do mean the company-wide amounts, not the amount for any one segment. Then we can find the break-even by product line by simply multiplying by the sales mix. So we'll take those overall sales dollars required and multiply by the sales mix for each product line. So really, it's a two-step process. First, you get the company-wide break-even point, and then you can calculate break-even for each product line. Let's take a look at an example. Safeco produces and sells two products. In the most recent month, the company sold 6 bicycle helmets for every 4 motorcycle helmets. Operating data is as follows. All right, so we see that sales total $125,000, with $75,000 coming from bicycle helmets and $50,000 coming from motorcycle helmets. The variable costs, $45,000 for bicycle helmets, $25,000 for motorcycle helmets, for a total of $70,000. And we get the resulting contribution margin. Now, fixed expenses for the entire company total $39,600. What is the overall break-even point for Safeco? So first we'll calculate the overall company-wide contribution margin ratio. So looking back at what's given, we would compute that by taking $55,000 divided by $125,000. That calculates to be 44%. So plugging into the contribution margin ratio method formula, we can say that sales dollars will be equal to $39,600 of total fixed cost plus zero profit at the break-even point divided by 0.44. Company-wide sales must be $90,000 in order to break even. B. What is the sales in dollars required for each product at the break-even point? So here's where we want to break it out between bicycle helmets and motorcycle helmets. So again, if you refer back to the information that was given, you can see that $75,000 of sales come from bicycle helmets and $50,000 come from motorcycle helmets for a total of $125,000. That's going to help us calculate the sales mix. For bicycle helmets, the sales mix is $75,000 of sales divided by $125,000 of sales, or 60%. For motorcycle helmets, sales are $50,000. Total sales are $125,000. So the sales mix is 40%. So now we can multiply by the overall break-even point of $90,000, and we will find that sales must be $54,000 from bicycle helmets at the break-even point. And $36,000 for motorcycle helmets at the break-even point. This will total $90,000. And so what we know is that the company has to sell $90,000 in order to break even. And in order to break even, $54,000 of those sales must come from bicycle helmets and $36,000 must come from motorcycle helmets. If the mix is any different than this, then we will not break even. C. If the sales mix were to shift toward bicycle helmets with total sales remaining constant, what is the effect on the overall break-even point for the company? Well, this will be determined by whether or not bicycle helmets are the most profitable product or the less profitable product. So let's take a look. Now we see that we have greater sales from bicycle helmets, but that does not mean they're the most profitable. With the information given, the best indicator of profitability is the contribution margin ratio for each of the individual product lines. So for bicycle helmets, that's going to be $30,000 divided by $75,000. And for motorcycle helmets, the contribution margin ratio is $25,000 divided by $50,000. So let's go make those calculations. $30,000 divided by $75,000, 40%. For motorcycle helmets, $25,000 divided by $50,000 is 50%. So we can see from this that motorcycle helmets have a higher contribution margin ratio. What that means is a greater percentage of sales of motorcycle helmets can go toward covering the company-wide fixed costs of $39,600 and then contributing toward profit. So bicycle helmets have a lower contribution margin ratio, and we're shifting toward greater sales of bicycle helmets. So the shift is toward more sales from your less profitable product. So what is that going to do to the break-even point? Will you have to sell more inventory or less inventory if you sell a greater proportion from your less profitable product? Hopefully you said that's going to increase the break-even point. All right, that's it for multiple product calculations for CVP analysis. As always, get some practice, and I'll see you in class.